Hey guys, welcome back. It is favorites time and I have just a few products to share with you guys. And these are things that I've been literally reaching for on a daily basis. So we're gonna go ahead and just jump right into it. So this is a shimmering body oil and it just has a bunch of like micro glitter in it. It's beautiful. It just glistens so beautifully. I love putting this in my chest area, my shoulders, and now that we're getting into the hotter months, I can totally see myself like putting a little bit on the back of my shoulders. Okay, then I have another one which is also kind of like a beachy type of thing. This is the Bumble and Bumble Surf Spray. I don't know where I got this, but I just randomly found it one day and I decided to give it a try because I've been wearing my hair like this a lot lately, like just wavy. I don't apply any heat to it. And it looks really good for the first couple of days, but you know, around the same time that you need dry shampoo, I feel like the rest of my hair also needs something to bring it back. So I'll apply this and it gives me my curls back and I love it. Basically, all you do is just spray it on your hair. I don't know how it would work if you have naturally straight hair. My hair is naturally already wavy, so it does enhance the curls for me and it doesn't leave it crunchy. It doesn't smell weird or anything like that. So next up, I have a face mask, which is also what I've been using to exfoliate my skin. This is by Origins. It's the Original Skin Retexturizing Clay Mask with Rose in it. And this is basically a clay mask that you apply over your skin and you leave it on for about 10 minutes. It has little beads in it. So after it dries, you add a little bit of warm water to your face and then you slowly massage it. And it also exfoliates your skin and it just leaves it so baby but smooth. I use it once a week. That's all I need to exfoliate my skin. Okay, so next up I have a bronzer, which is the bronzer that I'm currently wearing. This is by Gucci and it is in the color Indian Sand. I don't know if you guys can see that, but I have been using the heck out of this baby. It's so pretty. I thought it was matte when I first got it, but when I look at it, it does have a little bit of like micro shimmers in it, but it's still super pretty that I don't even care. It's so pretty. Definitely the perfect bronzing tone for my complexion. It's not too cool to where it looks totally unnatural in the warmer months, but it's not so warm that I can't use it like as a little bit of like contouring. And next I have a highlighter, which is also what I'm wearing today. And this is Brilliant by Hourglass. Before, whenever I wanted like that really pretty subtle glow, I used to use Candlelight by Kevin Aucoin, and this has replaced that because I can use this in both ways. I can use this in the way that I would use that one, which is just very light, like that glow from within look, or if I want like a really intense highlight, then I just wet it with some Fix Plus and bam, it's gorgeous. So I really like it. Speaking of yellow powders, I have been reaching for this one a lot lately. So this powder just looks so good under the eyes. And I've been getting questions from you guys, like, what powder are you wearing? This is what I've been wearing lately. I'm wearing it today under my eyes. I use it on top of my concealer to set it. And it just does a beautiful job of brightening. I don't bake with it because it can be a little bit drying if I try to bake with it. And I have been using it with this brush that I recently got. It's by Wayne Goss. And it is in the number 02. Oh my gosh, these two together. It's just so good. I think this and any loose powder, it would just be so perfect. Next, I have a oldie but goodie, and this thing has been through so much. It's just so beat up. I actually hit pan in one of the eyeshadows already, in the espresso color, and it's just, this color is just so perfect for all the time. I find myself reaching for it in the daytime, at night, when I want a dramatic look, when I'm missing a color. Like if another palette is missing a color, I'll go into this palette to use that color. Okay, so next I have two lip products that I have been dying over. The first one is a lip liner, and it took me so long to gravitate towards it because the color on the outside is so deceiving. I thought for the longest time that this was like a pale nude color, but it's not. It's this gorgeous, oh my gosh, that's so dirty. It's this gorgeous brown with a hint of pink to it. Look how gorgeous that is. I have been using this nonstop. It goes with everything. I'm using it today. I used it to lighten the liquid lipstick that I'm wearing a little bit. And the ColourPop liners are just so creamy. I mean, you guys saw how easily it glides on. So they're good to wear on their own, but not if you want to wear it on its own to have like a matte lip, because it does transfer. It does transfer like a lipstick. Did I say the name already? It's called BFF. Okay, the next color is also one that I'm wearing, and it is a liquid lipstick by Jouer. This is in the color Noisette. I have not been able to put this color down, you guys. It is so pretty, and I think I've worn it in like two past videos. I mix it up either with like a pink lip liner to make it a little pinkier, or with this lip liner to lighten it, or sometimes I just wear it on its own. If you're somebody that wants to get into that really trendy brown color that's going on right now, but you're not brave enough to do those really dark ones, this is such a good color. The formula is amazing. And bonus, it smells like cake, you guys. It smells so good. If you are interested in any of these Jouer lipsticks, you can get them at Nordstrom. But if you want to save 15%, you can use my affiliate code, which I don't remember what it is. I'll leave it written somewhere on here, but that can save you 15% site-wide. So just thought I'd throw that out there. You don't have to use it if you don't want to. But yeah, love it. Another favorite has been this Marc Jacobs gel liner in black. It is the creamiest, darkest and blackest eyeliner I've ever used, and I use this on my waterline. I have it on today, and it just makes it so easy if you're somebody that struggles with like putting on their bottom liner or tight lining because it's not creamy enough. Oh my gosh, try this. This stays put all day long. I like to always set it with powder, or I put like a darker eyeshadow on top of the eyeliner just so it doesn't move. But even without it, this stuff lasts so long. Oh, I forgot to tell you, I have a jewelry piece that I want to talk about, and it is this necklace. I got this from Bauble Bar. It's a monogram necklace. I've been wanting one of these for so long. They have like a mini, medium, large, and then XL. I got the size large. I actually bought this right after I did that Bauble Bar haul, and I had that discount code. I don't know that it's still good anymore, but it was like a 30% off discount code that I had for you guys. I used it to buy this. That bad that I use my own discount code. It's so pretty. So next I have a candle that I have been obsessed with, and this is my first time ever buying a Jo Malone candle. Peony and blush suede scented candle. Oh, this smells so good. It's a very sophisticated floral scent. I think the only other floral candle I've ever liked was from Diptyque, and it was like a roses candle. Roses, I think that's what it's called. And aside from that, I haven't been able to find another candle that's floral that I personally love until I found this one. Yeah, so I think that's all I have to share with you guys. So let me know in the comments one thing that you guys have been loving, whether it's a show or food. Oh yeah, I love food. Or makeup products or anything like that. And I will talk to you guys next time. Mwah. Bye.